Welcome to this important tutorial on how to image a new MLS computer. One key information that you will need to have with you before you begin the process is to have the unit number for this MLS computer. Okay, so if it's for NAVWA, you need to get NAVWA's unit number ready. Once you've set up the computer and you've plugged everything in, you've turned it on, you'll get this Dell logo screen that initiates the imaging process. You don't have to do anything here. Okay, now, I apologize for the quality of the video. I use my camera on my smartphone, so it's not as well done or quality, but you'll get the gist of what we're trying to do here with this tutorial video. Okay, now, you'll get to this particular screen here, the basic information that you will need to fill in. So you'll need to enter the country, your home country. For us is Fiji. You'll need the preferred app language to be entered in as well. Okay, so first of all, let's put in the country. You have to scroll all the way up. It's arranged in alphabetical order, so you go all the way up to F and look for Fiji. Okay, so that's your country. Add the language, which for us is English, more so English New Zealand, because that's the English we use here in Fiji. And of course the time zone, you will have to scroll all the way down to the Fiji time zone. Then once that's filled in, you go down to the bottom right corner and click on next. Okay, so this will restart the computer, and in this step-by-step tutorial, the computer will reboot itself a couple of times, so you just have to bear with this process initially for the first few minutes, because you will need to key in some of the important information, such as the unit number that we talked about initially. Okay, now this process takes about an hour and 30 minutes, 1 hour 30 minutes total on average. But I've sped up this speed of the video so that we don't have to be sitting here for the next hour and a half just to cover this tutorial. So I've doubled and tripled the speed of the video so we don't have to be here for too long. But again, this is for you to just get the gist of what we're trying to do when we image a new MLS computer. This only works when it's a new computer and not an old computer that you're trying to re-image. Okay, so again, it'll reboot itself. We don't have to do much here. Okay, so if this is an old MLS computer, there's a separate tutorial on how to re-image it. But for this particular case, this is a new MLS computer. It's going to be straightforward, and there's just a few moments where you have to type in key information, but the whole thing is automated to run on itself. Now, init user, that's the default user that the image will use. Once this is fully imaged, you will see that there will be a few other users that has been typed in or configured automatically. Now for this process, you will hit yes, and then hold on to your keyboard. You will hit spacebar right now so that it pauses this window, because we need to select a few more optional programs or software, such as Adobe Reader, which is what we need in all MLS computers, Kit PDF, and of course OpenOffice. You can choose LibreOffice, but we normally use OpenOffice for our Excel and Word documents and things of that nature, since we don't have Microsoft Office installed. Okay, so we use OpenOffice instead, and you can go ahead and there's nothing else. You can begin install by clicking on that button, and here we are installing the necessary programs. When it comes to this window, like I said, you will need a unit number for this computer, for this unit. I'm using this is for Navua Ward, so I have Navua's unit number ready, and I will type this in. And but if you don't know the unit number, you can go to your web browser and go to this website, cdol.lds.org. All Christian leaders, executive secretaries and clerks can access this website. It is a church-sponsored site where you can get those information that we just talked about. And then type in your LDS account username and LDS account password, and then sign in. And then on the top right corner, on the search field, you can type in the unit name. For me, this is for Navua unit, so I type in Navua. And that brings up this search result. And you see on the top left corner, I'm highlighting right now, that's the unit number for Navua. That's how I can get that. And I can even also get the state unit number, which I will need both. Both of these information I'll need later on when I configure MLS. So keep that in mind. That's how you can get the unit number. So here I type in the unit number for Navua to complete this step. So 317-543, select the country. In this case, we're in Fiji, so we select Fiji. I'm using the up and down arrow keys on the keyboard to do this quickly. Okay, Fiji, and then region, we are in the Pacific. And the rest, I leave it as it is. Okay. Language is English, of course, and I hit apply, and that takes care of the other steps. And sit back and relax while it installs all the other software that we have had selected, such as Adobe, MLS, OpenOffice, and so forth. Click done on the MLS. Okay, it's installing Adobe Reader, and soon this will reboot itself. Like I said earlier, this process, the whole thing, takes about 1 hour, 30 minutes on average. But I've sped up the video so that we can cover that in the next 30 minutes. Again, most of this you will just have to wait this out. It'll do most of the installation by itself, and now you'll be signed out shortly and rebooted to the login screen that we are waiting for, so we can configure the user. Okay, like I said, there will be three users that will be configured by default, and one was the init user that we had seen earlier, and one of the other two will be the unit that this computer is being configured for, which for my case, this is Navua MLS computer. And so this is the typical screen that we normally see. Use the mouse to click out of it. Init user is there. I also see another user called MHAdmin. We will talk about that as well. And then of course the unit for Navua. This is the unit account that they will be using. So the user must change the password before signing in. So you need your clock. It'll be good to have the clock for the unit to be there so they can set this password, or even one of the bishops, bishopric or branch presidency for the unit. Okay, click OK. The original password, there's none, so you don't type anything there, but you can go ahead and click on the middle field to type in the password. Okay, so this is again, this is a new password, initial password that they have to create. Okay, and then confirm, and then hit next, and now they are changing the password for the unit. Password has been changed, and we click on OK to go to the next step. Okay, sign in. Okay, so again, this is a Navu unit, and they have successfully signed in. Now we'll go back to the other account, MHAdmin. This is what you'll be using as an administrator if the clerk or anyone of the branch presidency or bishopric is not available. What you need to use is this password by first of all copying the service tag on the computer. It's a sticker that's on the outside of the PC. Okay, so those 7-digit numbers, DG9BHJ2. For Navua, that's their service tag for their computer. So again, I'm using their service tag to for the password for MHAdmin. Okay, so that's the service tag, which is DG9BHJ2. The username that I'll be using as initially setting up the computer is MHAdmin. The password I will use, by default, it comes as this: M, capital M, lowercase h, and then the last 5 digits of the service tag. And then don't forget the exclamation mark. Again, M, a capital M, small h, the last 5 digits of the service tag, which is 9, capital B, capital H, capital J, 2. And of course, don't forget the exclamation mark at the end. Okay, again, I'm highlighting this so you can see for all MLS computer, this is the password for MHAdmin. Okay, so I type those in and you should be able to log into MHAdmin so you can complete installing MLS software. Again, this is if you log into MHAdmin, if the clerk or any of the bishopric or branch presidency is not available to log into their unit account and change their password, then you need to use MHAdmin to log in. But if they're available, you don't need to use MHAdmin. Okay, so let's click OK. Setup is complete for MLS. And now we're gonna complete the final stages by configuring MLS appropriately for this unit. Okay, and that's for another tutorial that I will show you. Okay, so that's it for now. This is how we image a new MLS computer.